malamente como dos años es que empecé a sentir. Cuando yo estaba trabajando, me empezó a agarrar ese palpitamiento así bien fuerte, que hasta el color me cambiaba. Y más antes yo podía trabajar lo normal, y el cansancio que se siente lo normal, ¿va? Pero no así como me agarra.
You know how many times I've heard this? I have no idea what he has, but I have heard many Chagas patients say that.
Pues nosotros allí es campo. Ahí donde nosotros vivimos, allí no hay agua así potable. Nosotros, pues sí, hay pozos donde nace el agua y vamos a tener agua. No hay energía eléctrica, no hay calles así pavimentadas, el polvo.
¿Y tú te recuerdas de este insecto?
Sí, porque nosotros vivíamos en casas que no era casa así, no, que era casa de zacate, pues. Ponía el zacate arriba y zacate a los lados, y ahí vivíamos. En medio del zacate ahí nacían todos los animalitos esos.
Lorenzo came to me about a year ago, and at that time he was complaining primarily of palpitations and also some vague kind of chest discomfort. I have to admit, though, I didn't consider Chagas. Every medical student in the United States learns about Chagas, and then we go on and we practice medicine, and years go by. We don't think we see a case, and so we tend to drop it down on our index of suspicion. But on thinking about it and then talking with you, Rick, I began to wonder whether Lorenzo could possibly have Chagas disease, because one of the manifestations would be heart arrhythmias. He's otherwise appears very healthy, but he came from the environment where he could contract Chagas disease. So our intention is to test him for that and possibly even need to test his family.
I saw Lorenzo exactly 2 weeks ago today. And I asked him to come back today so we could check his blood for Chagas. We were going to draw the blood along with Olinda's and send both specimens to the CDC. Regretfully, I found out that Lorenzo was admitted to the local hospital over the weekend and died the day before yesterday. He died apparently from complications of heart disease.
I received the results of the blood test that we sent to the CDC, and I can tell you that Lorenzo's blood tested strongly positive for Chagas. Right. His tissues were harvested right after he passed away, and these were sent off for possible transplantation. However, given our suspicion of Chagas disease, we managed to stop this transplantation before it was done. But it does raise the problem of not testing for Chagas on patients whose tissues may be harvested, certainly in the population that comes from countries where it's endemic.